Okay, we're here at the house now, so we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna start with the driveway and the sidewalk. It's not in that bad of shape, really, to be honest with you. The driveway and sidewalk, it's gonna come clean really nice. And then that'll wake everybody up, and we'll get that garage door shut and give her a chance to let her dogs out, and then we'll go ahead and whip up the house for a quick house wash. Okay, here's the poopy part of what just happened. I brought my 50-foot garden hose with me for fresh water. And it's not long enough to take it all the way to the street so I can do the driveway without being in the way. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to wash this part of the driveway and sidewalks first where my fresh water hose will fit. Then I'll move my truck down here and then I'll wash up there in the walkway and then just do a final rinse and this will all be clean. Kind of sucks. Plenty of hose to park in the driveway and do a house wash. Not plenty of hose to reach from the spigot all the way down. I'm like 25 feet too short. Actually, I'm like 10 feet too short, but they don't, you know, hey, whatever. Something for you to think about. Okay, I've never used the extension on this, which I don't think I have, so I don't even know if I'm gonna be able to use this this wand. I don't know if it's gonna work for me, but I'm gonna try to put you guys where you're not gonna get too wet. Wind's going this way. I'll put you guys on an angle this way, and this is my customer, and this is my customer, but I do not go all the way, okay? I do her property line. So we're gonna go from here over. That's gonna look like crap. That's not her fault, and it's not for me to do because then the driveway looks like crap. So where does it end? It ends at the property line. That's how I do it. That's how I function. You do it how you want, but that's how I do it. It's definitely weird. It still feels like I might have a tip a little bit clogged up, but it should work its way out. Lift it up a little where the grass is so it gets all the way to the edge. Little loose dirt is just sitting on top. Let me give you a different angle. See what I mean? It's just loose dirt. I got a tip that's not working right. I'm gonna keep going though. Sounds like it just cleared out a little bit. So with the extension, you can see for real, I'm not bending over. So now I'll take the white tip, I'll rinse off this sidewalk and see what it looks like. Any little bit of strike, go ahead and hit it now. sidewalk. Nice. Okay, so my house is way over there, and I don't want to disconnect everything and drive there, and I don't want to walk there, but the O-ring blew out on one of my ends, and I didn't bring my toolkit with me, damn it. So I took the O-ring out of the extension, put it on my wand, so I'm without the extension now. done with all the concrete. I'll show you the finished product once it dries. I'm gonna wash this wall for you. Soft wash, black tip, 10% SH straight with an ounce of soap per gallon of SH in a white bucket, siphoning in. Here we go. There's my suds. I know I got a good siphon. This will not hurt the plants or the grass. It's just not strong enough. Gotta reach in behind all these bushes to try to get it. It's just about gone. That's about all that you need to do. It's just about gone. That's how you soft wash a vinyl house. I spray it on the brick, and I'll leave it on the brick. But if the brick was in bad shape, I would pressure wash the brick with my surface cleaner. I did a video of that. I'll link to it. I gotta keep you back here, or you'll get sick. Okay, look, when it comes to these vents, it's very low pressure, so you're not shooting water into those vents. She doesn't want to shut her garage door, so whatever. The windows spot up. Yes, they do. So rinse them well, and they won't. Rinse now until you get all the suds out. Once the suds are out, then you can start rinsing. There you go. My main focus is the windows. Make sure that they're clean, and anything metal, make sure that they're cleaned off so the bleach doesn't have any effect on the metal, any lasting effect. On the painted shutters, you see that? Just not thick enough. You know, the mix, it's not hot enough. SH to sit on the brick. It won't hurt the brick and the mortar. It's only gonna help. Volume with a 4 gallon per minute, but with the black tip, there's no pressure. All the spots that were here are gone. Nasty spots on there. Came right off with the bleach and soap, huh? So anyways, here we go. Give you guys a before, and then we'll blend it into the after. Looks pretty darn good. Those are tire tracks where my truck was parked when I rinsed. I'll get it with the garden hose. But there you go, huh? Done. House is washed, concrete's washed. Happy customer checking my hand. Let's go home.
Tell me about the whistle.